I'm Kevin, otherwise known as Form BX257, here to bring you another 1980s and 90s G.I. Joe toy review. And today I'll be taking a look at the G.I. Joe's Deep Water Specialist, the 1992 Deep Six, and his pet dolphin, Finback. Better known as Deep Six Version 3, part of a rare second series of Eco Warrior sub-team toys. Unfortunately, Deep Six does not make any cartoon or comic book appearances in his version 3 outfit. Taking a look at Deep Six's accessories first, starting off with his harpoon gun. This is the exact same mold as the one from the 1989 Deep Six. That one was done in gray plastic and not black like this. I'm still not sure of the practicality of having a scope on an underwater weapon, but well, there it is. Deep Six also comes with a pair of lovely pink flippers. Like all G.I. Joe flippers, they are universal fit, so that there is no left or right that you have to look out for. Interestingly enough, I may have been mistaken in saying that these were the exact same mold as the ones from the 1992 wetsuit figure. However, they are different. As I don't know which figure was produced first, either the 1992 wetsuit figure or the 1992 Deep Six figure, but as you can see, one is clearly a modification of the other because they are just so similar in how they look, especially the front ends of the flippers. However, it appears that Deep Six has a much bigger foot than Wetsuit does. Coming standard on all 1992 figures was a black plastic figure stand, which is some Hasbro copyright information on the back here. And finally, we have Finback the Dolphin. Not so much an accessory, more like an animal companion. He is, in fact, at the time of his making, the largest G.I. Joe animal companion ever made. As a matter of fact, he's still kind of up there for the 3¾-inch figures. You can see that he does have some copyright information stamped on his belly, rather unfortunately. Now, all of the Eco Warrior figures had two gimmicks, and one of them was a water firing feature. Most of the figures actually came with a pump with a hose on it as an accessory. However, for Deep Six, he came with the Dolphin to do that job. So he isn't a hard plastic dolphin, he is actually rather squishy because he has a little hole in between his teeth here. And what you're supposed to do, you're supposed to dip him into some water, squeeze him, release it, so that the pressure fills up with water. Then you point it at a target, squeeze it again, so that you get a stream of water shooting at your bad guy. Before I get into the figure, it is interesting to note that starting in 1992, they started itemizing some of the stuff on the figure on the file cards. So not only does it list in detail what the accessories are, but it also shows you exactly some of the accessories molded onto the figures of what they're supposed to be doing. I'll let you read the file card at your leisure just to see the stuff that they pointed out, but there are at least two things which are very interesting, at least to me. And one of them is that they pointed out this little pouch on his chest here as being the ammo cartridges for his harpoon gun. Well, I called it a harpoon gun, but according to the file card, it is an AVB-40 laser gun. Whatever. And the other thing is his aqua amplified thrusters here. So these little things on his ankles here are actually tiny little jet propulsion units. That's a very interesting little touch. Sadly, Deep Six's faceplate does not come off. Well, I mean, it does, but you wind up cracking it off. It has four little pins in here, but it's also glued on top of that. As a matter of fact, most visors, which aren't supposed to come off, usually come off simply because the glue just sort of dries up over time. However, Deep Six's is very unique in that the pegs are reportedly very tight to the holes in the molded head here. So even if you do try to take this off after the glue has dried, you're most likely to have cracked those pegs holding the thing on in the first place. However, I will show a picture of what one looks like without the faceplate so you can get a good look at what his face actually looks like. Although personally, it doesn't really look like the same face of the previous Deep Six or even the one before that. And now to take a look at his overall look, I really do like the dark blue jumpsuit, but they've went and paired it up with some very, very bright colors. Now again, I know I make this excuse a lot, especially with pilots and sailors, because they usually do wear some bright things on them just so that they can be seen by friendly forces in the middle of the night or in dark, dark waters. But here, I'm not really sure about the use of bright pink on this fellow. Of course, I do like all the little accessories that they have put on him. A little knife here, and of course, little breathing tubes and stuff like that. Despite the weird parts taken out of context, he is, as a whole presentation, really nice looking. Especially if you really consider him to be more of a dolphin trainer than an actual deep sea diver. As a matter of fact, I'm a little bit sad that they got rid of most of his armored look from his two previous versions and gave him more of a scuba suit look, because now he doesn't look so much like a deep sea diver than he does a scuba diver. But again, you know, with the Finback dolphin accessory, it actually makes a bit more sense. And then there's a very interesting little thing which all of the Eco Warrior figures had, or at least the G.I. Joe versions had, and that is the Eco Warrior symbol on the side here, on his bicep. Now, it's really hard to see on a lot of the other figures because they're mostly brightly colored figures with also brightly colored paint jobs on top of that. But here, we can actually see more of a contrast with the dark and white on top of it. And you can clearly see, and again, I might have to put this in pictures, but this thing actually says Enviroforce, not Eco Warriors at all. Now the second gimmick is related to the first one, in that the figures all had some type of color change paintwork on them, and that you had to spray cold water onto the figures in order to activate that. Now that's one of the reasons why Deep Six here has that strawberry jam like stain on his wetsuit. That is actually the color change thing just sort of peeking through the color. It was never totally invisible, even back in the day. And unfortunately, a lot of people have discovered that this color change paintwork is actually a different type of paint than regular action figure paint, in that it is kind of waxy and it can be scraped off and it can just simply not change colors anymore. Mine is kind of subtle and takes a long time, but it still does kind of change colors, even though you can kind of see it. And also, yeah, this little example here is a little bit deceptive. It was never that radical of a change. And here I have a little cup of water here. Ice cold water, in fact. I would suggest that if you want to change the color, you should actually warm up the figure first so that it's at its, maximum invisibleness before you dunk it into the cold water to see the dramatic change. So here we go. Just sort of dunk him in here for a little bit. Like I said, this it does change, at least my figure does change still, but I can see it wearing off like within the next couple of years or so. And if you pull him out, dry him off a tiny little bit, you can see that, well, it is sort of there. I mean, you can see it more up the figure now than it was before, but yeah, a little bit on his waist a bit more prominently. But yeah, I mean, you really have to dunk this figure in here and wait for a good 5 minutes before it changes. Being splashed by a water gun with cold water is just not going to do it for a figure this old now. I simply couldn't do an Eco Warriors Deep Six review without mentioning this, the rare Deep Six with quote-unquote killer whale. When the figure was first produced, a few prototype test shots of the dolphin in black were put on production card backs for quality assessment. Instead of going back directly to Hasbro, these were released. I won't point fingers as to why or how, and all quickly fell into collectors' hands. It is unknown how many there are, but I personally have never seen any more than three in my 20 plus years of collecting. Hype quickly grew for what speculators assumed was a variation, and information on them is often incorrect. This is a typical entry on this toy, and it is full of errors, from the number released to the fact that Finback wasn't originally designed as a dolphin. As you can see from Hasbro's own 1992 Toy Fair photos, the pre-production resin mock-up of Finback is very much a dolphin, with blue painted eyes no less. This isn't even the only prototype color accessory to be put on a production card back. For instance, these items with the same problem come from Hasbro employees and are rarer. However, the myth surrounding the killer whale variant gives it a huge boost in value over any similar item. Now, if the idea of a killer whale companion for Deep Six sounds a bit more appealing than maybe a dolphin, or if you're like me and you don't particularly care for the water-squirting gimmick on this figure, you should try this modification, which I did. That is, replace the dolphin with this, a bona fide killer whale action figure. That's right, this thing is not just a figurine, it is actually an action figure. It has articulation and everything. This is a killer whale from Tomy's line called the Anawa line, and it has an articulated little jaw and a 3-point articulated tail. So that's quite a bit of action. It is actually kind of the same scale as the dolphin was. The dolphin is actually a little bit chubbier, but overall this kind of looks like how a killer whale accessory would have been like for a figure. And here we have a timeline of G.I. Joe Deep Six figures in my collection. These are three out of the four produced for the vintage line. This is the 84 version, the 89 version, and of course the 1992 version, which we're talking about now. However, there is a 1993 version, which was a mail-away exclusive, basically a recolor of the 1989 figure. Interestingly enough, we do have kind of a lineage between these figures, even though they look completely different. Of course, we have the same molded weapon. Here, here was a harpoon gun, I'm pretty sure of that. But here they're just calling it a laser gun because, I guess, the 90s. However, he does have a gimmick, just like this figure does. This one was not really an action figure, but kind of just a walking gimmick in the guise of an action figure. We pumped air into him and he either rose in water or he sank in water. So we have kind of the same pumping gimmick between these two, so it's kind of coming full circle, at least in a retail sense. And while I do like the whole presentation of all of this going on here, I still kind of like the old copper helmeted, deep sea diver. He's very traditional looking, and I kind of do like this 89 version out of all of them. The second series of Eco Warriors figures released in 1992 only had three new figures. One of them was a zombie for the Cobra Forces, one of them was a firefighter for the G.I. Joe Forces, and the other was a deep-sea diver. And while they all make legitimate cases for being environmental fighters, of course there's a lot of pollutants being thrown into the sea, unfortunately, there was no opposite number on the Cobra side for Deep Six here, which was very surprising. It's almost as if they were sort of missing a figure from that line. They just released the one zombie figure, unfortunately. So in the same year, there were a lot of aquatic vehicles and figures released for G.I. Joe, more so than any other year, really. And the opposite number for him, I believe, was from the basic line, and that is the second version of the Cobra Eels. Not only do we have a very similar color scheme with the blue bodysuit with very bright pops of color on top of that, but this version of the Eels also came with a companion in the form of a robotic shark, which was a gimmick and a very strange gimmick, pretty much equal to this water spouting dolphin, I would say. If you're looking for a 1992 Eco Warriors Deep Six on the aftermarket, I am sorry to say that he is actually a fairly hard figure to find complete with all of his parts, and even when you do, he is kind of expensive on the aftermarket for a couple of reasons. One very interesting thing, however, is that the hardest part to find out of all of his accessories is the giant dolphin. Now, I'm not sure why this thing is always separated, but there have been some speculations on the forums of collectors. Some saying that some people don't realize that the dolphin is part of the accessories of the G.I. Joe figure, and they think that this is some type of a bath toy which got mixed in with the toy box and often separated it. Another faction is saying that a lot of kids at the time may not have been so impressed with a dolphin being an accessory if it had been like a killer whale, which is a lot cooler sounding and maybe cooler looking. They might have kept it with the figure. Instead, they might have just originally thought that it was kind of lame and just sort of gave it to their little sisters instead to play with. Another very interesting thing is the faceplate. Now, normally when I see like visors and stuff like that, which aren't supposed to come off, you can still find them on the aftermarket. But not so with Deep Six. I've never seen the faceplate by itself on the aftermarket. So if you're trying to get a complete figure and you have one without the faceplate and you're thinking, well, I'll be patient and try to find the faceplate and glue it on at a later time, well, I don't know if that's a good idea because, like I said, I've never seen the faceplate just by itself in a parts lot. Of course, the other accessories are usually with the figure. Of course, some sellers don't really consider the black battle stand to be part of the figure, but let's face it, black battle stands are fairly a common accessory to find even by themselves, so you can just add it to them whenever you want to. But yeah, the other unfortunate thing with this figure is the infamy of the black dolphin killer whale thing, where some people consider that a variation and they look for it and they settle for this instead, driving up the price. But yeah, these things kind of run for quite a bit of money on the aftermarket, whether they're on the card or just loose like this. Some people ride a jet ski into battle, but not Deep Six. He rides a dolphin. Oh yeah. G.I. Zoo. Whoop. Well, that's all the time I have right now. Please check out my Facebook page for more information and behind-the-scenes photos for these reviews. Thank you for watching this video, and stay tuned for next time to see another 1980s G.I. Joe tour review. See you then.